Egypt, more than 3,000 years ago, the art of ploughing was held in high esteem. The oldest German law book, the Illustrated Saxon Spiegel, tells us that the farmer owed much of his wealth to the plough. The straight furrow became the symbol of the straightforward character of the farmer. Here is the oldest German plough, 4,000 years old. It was discovered at Vala and is known as the plough of Vala. Even then, this plough was no longer a primitive plough. It incorporated the conventional stilt and a foot or share made of oak. At the end of the 10-foot long beam is a wooden hook to which the draft animals were harnessed. It has all the basic elements which we still find in our present-day ploughs. In the historical plough exhibition at the Agricultural College of Hohenheim, we can follow the development of the plough. The wooden share of the hook plough is considerably improved by iron mountings. These ploughs only scratch the ground. The importance of good ploughing was soon realized, and in Europe, further developments and consequent improvements in plough design followed. To improve the operation of the plough, the beam was mounted on a forecarriage. With the introduction of the new mould board, the soil could be turned to the side. With this one-way plough, the soil can only be turned in one direction. The farmer had to divide his field into plots. With ploughs of this kind, the prairies of North America were cultivated. The first ploughs, completely made of iron with mould board and share of steel, were built by the Belgians and the English. From now on, ploughs were manufactured on an industrial scale. And in the middle of the 19th century, the first plough factories were established. The work of the plough manufacturer was then, as it is today, based on the experience of the farmers. The development of many varieties of plough is due to the variation of soils and landscapes. On the wide plains of the Lüneburg Heath in Norman Germany, with its light and sandy soils, we still find the simplest form of plough, the swing plough. This plough has no support whatsoever and is freely movable in all directions. The ploughman has to counterbalance all stresses applied to the plough by applying pressure to the stilt. In hilly areas, the one-way plough cannot be used. The irregular shape of the fields renders ploughing of separate plots very difficult. The soil has to be turned towards the slope. Here, the reversible plough is used in its simplest form, the turnrest plough. This type of plough is also comparatively light, permitting a depth of furrow of some 7 inches. After releasing the shift lever, the plough body is turned round on an axle along the middle of the mould board. The cylindrical mould board is fitted with 2 shares, one on the upper side and the other on the lower side. With this construction, the farmer can return in the same furrow. Where hedges divide the field, it is important to plough close to the edge of the field so that valuable land will not be left uncultivated. For heavy soils, a more advanced form of the reversible plough was constructed. Turning of the beam, to which 2 complete plough bodies were fastened, is affected by rolling the plough bodies over the soil. The rigid locking device between the beam and the forecarriage and the weight of the upper plough body ensure a good self-operation and a regular penetration in the soil. Because of these advantages, this kind of reversible plough is widely used. In mountain farming, cultivation is difficult. Steep slopes have to be ploughed. This demands special skill of ploughman and a draft animal. The plough also had to be adapted to the requirements of the landscape. The reversible plough developed into the quarter-turn plough. The bodies of the quarter-turn plough stand at right angles to each other. To reverse, it has to be turned only through 90 degrees. The idle body ensures a good bite of the plough in the soil. Even on a 30-degree slope, the furrow can still be turned upwards. The deep soils of the lower Rhine area permit the cultivation of wheat and sugar beets. The reversible ploughs, shown so far, are too light for this purpose, because a deep furrow has to be ploughed. In consequence, the balance plough was developed, which permits furrows of a depth of up to 12 inches and more. In order to reach such a depth, the plough must be heavy. Two complete ploughs are here combined in one unit, which, in spite of its weight, can easily be turned about the axle of the carriage. When turning, the draw chain is drawn underneath the land wheel. In the course of development, the plough bodies were standardized. With the introduction of the automobile, agriculture also became motorized. The high speed of ploughing influenced changes in the shape of the plough bodies. But even the modern hydraulic-mounted plough still retains the mouldboard of long standing. Ploughing techniques, however, changed. The horse ploughman walked behind the plough and was able to watch his work. The tractor ploughman has the plough behind him, and his attention is divided between the plough and the tractor. Using high tractive power, there is a tendency to pay insufficient attention to proper and careful ploughing. This would lead to a decrease of the soil fertility. Through ploughing competitions, the Rural Youth Advisory Service awakens the young people's desire to qualify in their work. Everyone can participate in a county match organized by an agricultural school. Ploughing matches are nothing new. They were already held in the 19th century. The young farmer can compare his own ability with that of others. Through county and regional matches, the winners finally take part in the federal ploughing match. Everybody who has taken part in a ploughing match, no matter whether on county or federal level, knows just how much care and skill is required to satisfy the judges. It is not the prize that matters, but the joy of doing a perfect job, which encourages more than 10,000 young farmers in Germany to participate in such matches every year. Every competitor works with the same tractor and plough he uses at home. It is not speed, but the accuracy of the work which is the deciding factor. The judges assess the quality of the work before making a final decision, which is anxiously awaited before distribution of the prizes. The high standard of the ploughing of all participants confirms the value of the ploughing matches. The federal ploughing champions will represent Germany in the World Ploughing Contest.